Hi guys, I'm Phil O'Neill from Australia, and I hope you're having a fantastic day. James Morrison is one of the best trumpet players in the world. It's unbelievable what he can do on the trumpet, and if you are playing trumpet, the chances are you know his name and you have listened to several of his recordings, whether it be something on YouTube, whether it be one of his albums, whatever it is, whether it's the Olympic Games in 2000 when he opened the ceremony, or it could even be when he got the Spanish anthem wrong. Chances are, if you're a musician, you have heard James Morrison's music. Being a Sydney-sider and living in Australia, I've been fortunate enough to do several gigs with James Morrison. And I constantly learn from him about playing music and about being a musician. And I just wanted to share the top five things that I have learned from James Morrison. These are in no specific order. They are just five things that I've learned from James himself that I think are really, really valuable, and I've been able to apply them to my journey as a musician, and I think you guys will benefit from them greatly as well. So, let's get started. Number one, practice hard to achieve your goals, but make sure you enjoy the journey. James is a big believer in hard work. I mean, his playing on the trumpet alone speaks for itself, but he's able to play the trumpet, the trombone, the saxophone, the bass, that pretty much any instrument he wants to play, he's learned it, right? And he's learned it to an incredibly high standard. He's recorded entire big band albums where it's just him and a drummer. Now, he loves to tell this story about how when he was younger and trying to learn how to play in the upper register, he would often play and in the upper register until he got nosebleeds. And he said he would do that frequently. Now, I'm not suggesting you go and play in the upper register to get nosebleeds, because there are other ways to do things, right? But that's a sign of how hard he has worked to achieve what he has achieved. At the same time, make sure you have fun doing what you're doing. Now, James is always having fun. Whether I've played with him or whether I've just watched his gig, he's always having fun. Even around having a couple of drinks after the gig, he's having fun. He loves to socialize. He loves spending time on the stage. He just loves what he does, no matter what he's doing. So that's really important as well, because if you're not having fun, you can't achieve the results because it feels like too much hard work. Tip number two, if you want to play multiple instruments, practice the change. Don't pick up one instrument and play it for the day, and then the next day you pick up the different instrument and you play that one for the day. You need to practice the change. You need to be good at changing between the two instruments. Okay. Now, he uses this to describe how he learned how to play trombone, right? Now, he played trumpet, got that feeling comfortable, then he played trombone, played the trombone till that felt comfortable, then he'd go back to the trumpet and get that feeling comfortable, back to the trumpet, trombone, trumpet, trombone, trumpet, trombone, and he would do this until he would be able to pick up the trumpet, play whatever he wanted to play on the trumpet, then go straight to the trombone and play whatever he wanted on the trombone without doing a warmer. How is this useful to trumpet players? Well, check out all those trumpets up there. Every single one of those trumpets up there is a version of the trumpet that I play almost every single day. Now, I've got B flat, I've got C, I've got D, I've got E flat, I've got rotary, I've got cornet, I've got piccolo trumpet. As a classical trumpet player, primarily a classical trumpet player, I need to be able to change between those instruments without playing any notes in between. I need to be able to pick it up and have it sound great. And I've been able to learn that skill by applying the knowledge from tip number two of practice the change. Tip number three, telling an amazing story is more important than being able to play high, fast, or loud. And that's coming from someone who does all three incredibly well. If you've seen James perform live, he is a showman. He is very, very good at it. He has a lot of charisma, and he tells a lot of stories. He often tells stories with his words that correlate or help us understand more or relate more to the story he tells with his music. It's really important that we tell stories with our music, because otherwise High and Loud becomes boring after a while. Number four, putting yourself out there is the best way to create opportunities. One of the favorite stories that James loves to tell, and I've heard this so many times on every gig that he does, and I love this story, is when he and his brother John, the drummer, are traveling, and I think it's through New York, and they have no money, no accommodation, and no food. So John and James, James and John, go busking in New York on the street. An amazing musician, amazing pair of musicians, busking on the street to try and make enough money to get a bed and a feed for the night. While they're busking, an event manager for a venue, for a live music venue, sees them, approaches them and says, "Hey guys, I've got a cancellation for tonight. Do you guys want to play?" Paid gig because they went busking. I created this YouTube channel to put myself out there in the hopes that it would create opportunities. And fortunately, it has created opportunities for me. So that's just my story on how me putting myself out there has created opportunities for me. So you should do the same. Put yourself out there and I'm sure it will create opportunities for you too. And number five, give back to the future generation of musicians. James does so much to help develop young musicians everywhere he goes. He performs with schools all over the country. I'm sure he does it internationally as well, but he definitely does it in Australia. In fact, most schools that have a good music program, James will perform with them at some point to help inspire them to continue doing music and to do music as well as they can. James started in 1992. He started Generations in Jazz, which is a stage band competition. Last I went there, there were three divisions. There were so many school bands competing that there were three divisions across four different stages or five different stages. That's unbelievable. And he has a university that he teaches at regularly. Now that is generosity. That's giving back to the future generation of musicians, right? And it's unbelievable how someone of his caliber is prepared to do that. These are the best five things that I've learned from James Morrison. They've helped me with my career and helped me advance in my career. And I'm sure they'll help you advance in your trumpet playing or your musical journey. If you're a fan of James Morrison's music, give this video a thumbs up. If you want a good practice routine to help you advance in 30 minutes a day, check out my free guide, Play Like a Pro, on the side. As always, happy practicing.